exactly a first choice regular for Inter Milan. He's a holding midfielder or number 10. He has actually made his debut, made 16 minutes against Betis. Salva Sevilla. Getting the ball across to Montañez. Caicedo. Free kick for Real Madrid. Vasquez. Moreno looking lively, just skips past Pepe, but some decent covering there from Real Madrid. Game has very much dropped a level, hasn't it, since the start of the second half. I think Espanyol know they ain't going to get anything from this. From Madrid, quite happy to conserve a bit of energy. Good run by Carvajal. Decent cross as well, but it's sliced clear by Alvaro. Gonna see former Espanyol winger Lucas Vazquez get into the action soon. Isco takes a cross, and Pau makes a save. Paco Montañez. See a decent covering though. From Real Madrid, Kovacic involved there. Although Espanyol end up forcing a corner. Cleared, it's dropped to Bale. It's a Gareth Bale. Just a little bit too far away from his scope. Bale's there, and Cristiano makes it 5-0. The second assist of the game for Bale, fourth of the match, fourth goal of the match, that is, for Cristiano. No offside there from Bale. You see his pace takes him behind the defence, and an easy finish for Cristiano. Five-nil to Real Madrid. Benzema gets the rest, and Lucas Vazquez comes in. I don't think he's going to get many appearances this summer. This season, but a popular player, did very well at Espanyol last year when he was on loan. If some people might just start to leave their seats soon in Cornea, miss the traffic. A few people just on the far side, they're just getting up and looking about, maybe it's time to go home. In some ways you could say the Bale forcing a penalty. Montaigne, yes, appeals for penalty. To see the Espanyol players still passionate about things, even though the 5-0 down. Ricardo Garrido saying, no, let's have a look. Once again, it's got to say, it's ball to hand. There's no unnatural movement there of Marcelo's arm. It just hits him. It does hit his arm, but where the rule is, if it's not deliberate, if you're not making an unnatural movement of your arm, it's not a penalty. Years ago, that might well have been given. I think the way things are now, it's the correct decision. Victor scythes that one over. Oh, look, it does hit his arm, but look, is there any unnatural movement there from the player, is what you're going to say? Is his arm out to stop the ball, or is it just there because that's what you do when you're a player? And his arm's right next to his body. Another substitution for Espanyol. I think it was Victor who goes off, and he is replaced by Jordan. Who is wearing the number 19 shirt? Juan Jordan. Before the game, Paulo Lopez said it was the time to beat Real Madrid. Well, one day that time will come. I suspect it ain't going to be this year. Caicedo cleared bravely there by Carvajal, all scrambled away. Kovacic is pulled out. And that'll be a booking for Kanyas, who pulled down the Croatian. Ramos. It's Lucas. So playing against his former club, overhits that one. Okay, there's no need, but it's good commitment with the game 5-0. Again, that's going over the top. But Powell, who has been basically helpless on all of the goals. Makes a claim. Cañas, flirting. With danger. Montañez. Caught by Kovacic. Oh, he's going to pick up his first booking in Spanish football. Doesn't time that particularly well, does he? And takes out Montañez. So free kick for Espanyol, 21, 22 minutes on the clock, left on the clock. Osier really to be forced into a save. This time, as he always has just been fired wide. He went wide, let's have a look. Spectacular effort there from Joan Jordan. But once again, not troubling the goalkeeper. Sergio's got a few things to ponder, as one suspects. Look at that, his side have had as many shots as Real Madrid in this game. Although they weren't from such good positions, a couple of Madrid's three of Madrid's goals basically being tap-ins just after nicely worked move, but as many shots from Espanyol as Real Madrid, and they have not scored. I don't think they've even had a shot on target. Twenty minutes to go. Gerard Moreno, one of the very few bright spots today for Espanyol, the former Villarreal striker. Espanyol enjoying a bit of possession here, Salva Sevilla. Marcelo's had a clip on it. There's Montañez. Take the throw in. he scored back deep. Sure, Ramos was flying there. Makes a second interception, though, to make up for it. Puts Isco into trouble. Chance for Espanyol! Oh, my word! How on earth did he miss that? Salva Sevilla misses the absolutely unmissable, but a great save from Keyla. Gets down brilliantly well. And it would only have been a little bit of makeup on the result there for Espanyol, but that's a great save from Navas, which leads to a horrible miss from Salva Sevilla. Ronaldo again, forcing a corner, blocked by Alvaro. And Varane's also going to get into the game. Ramos is the player to leave. And he is replaced, as we say, by Rafael Varane. Third substitution for Real Madrid this afternoon. There you go. Anyhow, he'll have just over 15 minutes, Rafael Varane. Speed from Lucas, looking to get into the penalty area. Caicedo. Salva slips there. And Pau makes a comfortable claim. Arbilla. Salva. slowly but surely thinning out. It's a bit of it lackluster, but Real Madrid, Espanyol, but Real Madrid have defended solidly when they needed to, it has to be said. Madrid's meanness at the back, and I think you shouldn't, although people have talked about Madrid not scoring goals, it shouldn't be forgotten that so far this season they haven't conceded any either, you know, which is something that Rafa Benitez needed to sort out. Maybe last year they lost the title because they conceded too many soft goals. They had to defend, they've done so in numbers and very effectively. Carvajal. Now you see Espanyol actually putting together more passes than Real Madrid. A higher percentage of passes flat finding their man and more passes, but they've all, it's all been a bit sterile, and Real Madrid far, far more effective in front of goal. Another chance, Cristiano scores his fifth of the game, and it's 6-0. It's again a little bit too easy there for Real Madrid. Five goals for Cristiano. Nice work from Lucas. Gareth Bale once again involved. Lucas Vazquez. Oh, lovely little shimmy. And again. 6-0. 5 to Cristiano. So rumours of his disappearance were slightly unfounded. Free kick for Real Madrid, and that has started the exodus. Ronaldo again. Will he be looking for a double hat-trick? So he scored against Espanyol last season. He scored 5 against them today. It's the case of, can we play you every week, isn't it, for Cristiano against Espanyol? Michaela once again, good handling. She's not really had much to do, Caelan Navas. One excellent save. We should still have been punished. But everything he does seem to do securely. Makes you wonder why Real Madrid, well, obviously they see De Gea as the future, perhaps. But came out today that Real Madrid not signing De Gea, actually cost them €16 million because they had an agreement with the keeper, which they can't publicise, obviously, because of FIFA rules, etc. If he didn't sign, they'd pay him compensation. They've had to pay the compensation. They bought Casilla. They're going to have to up Navas's wages. And Iker Casillas, who left so that... Hang on a second. Just why? Iker Casillas, who left so that De Gea could come, they're still paying two-thirds of his wages at Porto. So it's turning out to €16 million. If they do want to sign De Gea now, even if De Gea has a buyout clause in his contract, he doubt he'd be left €50 million. So it's not great, that, is it? €16 million to not sign somebody. Long faces among the Espanyol fans. As Lucas again, he's looked good since coming on, sets up Cristiano. And that's cleared. It's getting very painful for Espanyol fans at the moment. Carvajal goes for glory, goal kick. Isco. I think everyone at Real Madrid has played very much within themselves today. Casemiro showing a nice, a good start on his return. Salva Sevilla. Another free kick there. Clock's just dying down on this game at the moment. One of these games where you'd think that the referee is not going to have too much injury time. Really ought to be accomplished. Once again, Lucas Vázquez. former Espanyol player. John, a good save from Powell. He's probably grateful he's been able to save one. He's not actually had many chances to get a hand on the ball in this game. Really, Cedo puts the ball wide. Hasn't been that great, but it was all over basically by the 20th minute when Cristiano Ronaldo completed his hat-trick. There's never going to be any way back into it for Espanyol. Benzema making it 4-0 after a lovely move involving Gareth Bale, who's not scored but has been involved in lots of Real Madrid's moves, it has to be said. 4-0 on 28 minutes, 5-0 on the hour when Ronaldo scored his fifth, and 6-0 after that good work by Vazquez, who's certainly taken advantage of his few minutes on the pitch. Very much so. Oh, into injury time. And Mr. Vicandi Garrido, I think, doing the wise thing. There's no point in prolonging it. The game isn't actually going to change anymore. He's done Espanyol a favour. 90 minutes, no injury time. Final whistle. There you see it in blue and white. Espanyol 0, Real Madrid 6. Four goals, five goals from Cristiano Ronaldo and one from Karim Benzema. In which Cristiano's and the rumours of his demise proved very much to be exaggerated. Hope you've enjoyed it. Till next time, goodbye.